Welcome, my dear brothers and sisters. It's great to see all of you on this episode today. How are you, Pastor G, today?
Very good, Sataji. Finally got to go home and...
I can see through the nice new shirt, T-shirt yes, that you are wearing.
Yes.
But you know, even if I change or I don't change, nobody knows.
Nobody knows. That is true.
That doesn't mean I'm not changing.
You know? I know. You know, one time I was watching a show.
Mm-hmm.
It was about this fellow who is a driver, like. So they go into his room and open his closet. And he has all black suits.
Oh.
And nice white shirt with a black tie. All laid out every time. That's all he wore.
Sounds like me.
Yes.
So you can't really tell any difference, you know.
That's right.
Whether they are wearing new clothes
or the
or
same clothes.
Old clothes or same clothes all the time.
Yeah.
Acha, so how's everybody in the family?
Everybody's doing very well. Thank you.
How's your new son-in-law?
Oh, he's doing wonderful. You know.
And your tall grandson.
Oh, he's doing good. He's doing really good. You know, he's getting ready to go to college.
And growing tall.
Growing tall, yes.
Never stop.
He's my bodyguard, you know.
Right.
So people have angels that the book of Hebrew talks about. You know, they are assigned angels for every person who's saved. I have two. I have my grandson and my angel.
Praise God. And that boy is really tall.
He's grown, really
and
grown.
Big.
Yes.
No one can say he's 17.
No.
Or 18.
He's going to be 18 in February.
He looks big.
Yeah, he does. He's
so blessed with such a good height.
Yes, he is.
And how's your dear wife?
She's doing very well, sir.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Doing good.
So, last night, after our discussion, were you able to sleep peacefully?
Yes. Wonderful.
Any thoughts what we discussed?
Yeah, I was, you know, pondering on what we had discussed. And as we read, you know, we were discussing those things that were going to be open. It made me understand and realize how close we are to the end time. You know, we are very close. And I kept thinking last night that, you know, it's time to prepare ourselves. Because, you know, it's one thing if the angel comes, brings the scrolls, opens the mysteries of God. But if we are not trying to learn about God and get close to God, they will still stay mysteries.
You know, concerning the mysteries, it is a multi-dimensional revelation.
Yeah.
For example, you brought your Bible.
No? Yes.
In Revelation chapter 5, I'll show you something that may astound you.
Okay.
Okay. Many times, we just read through scriptures.
Yeah.
And the details sometimes eludes our understanding or our attention. Unless, until the Spirit of the Living God highlights them to us.
Yes.
In Revelation chapter 5, you'll find that after the Lord Yeshua has received the seven sealed scroll from God the Father, then all the 24 elders are bowing down to worship Him.
Yes.
But before that, they don't seem to do that. Why?
Well, because I think is when the scroll is given, there were some mysteries.
Okay, let me put this question differently.
Okay.
Let's suppose the opening of Congress. All the senators, congressmen will wait for the president, you know?
Correct.
They all are seated.
Yes.
As soon as the president walks in, everybody will stand up.
Yes.
To give their respect to the head of state.
Yes.
They will not be seated, and after the president has walked in, They all still sitting, right. And after half an hour, then they all stand up,
right,
and pay the respects. They don't do that.
No, no.
But here you read in Revelation chapter 5, mm-hmm, you'll read in verse 1 that God is seated on the throne, mm-hmm, with a seven seal scroll. Ah. And all the 24 elders are round about the throne.
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
I'm not saying anything beyond the Bible, no?
Right.
So all the 24 elders are round about the throne. Mm-hmm. And all the living creatures are round about the throne.
Yes.
Right, Pastor
right.
Ji? Okay. Right. Then, verse 6 tells us, mm-hmm, the Lamb of God, mm, and who's that?
The Son.
Right?
Right.
There's no other interpretation, no?
No.
It's the Lord Yeshua.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
The Lamb appears, but it says the Lamb.
Right.
It doesn't say
Yeshua.
It is the Lord Yeshua.
Right.
It's the Lamb. Everybody sees a Lamb.
Right.
An animal Lamb.
Right.
Okay? Now, you know English grammar very well, no?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. For humans, we'll use the word he or she to address.
Yes.
When addressing a human.
Right.
For animal, we use the word it.
Yes.
So we say it came, it went. Uh-huh. Am I right?
Right.
Indian English same as British, American right. English, no?
Right.
Okay. With that in mind, please look at the scripture carefully. Mm-hmm. You know, for a long time, even I myself didn't understand until the respected prophet of God, Vincent Salukumar, had a mighty visitation from God. Mm. Powerful encounter. He was allowed to see his whole sin.
Wow.
And he shared this publicly at our Metagoshen Prophetic Conference last year.
Okay.
So, very marvelous visitation he was graced by God to see, no? Mm-hmm. And that's when he was very amazed to see something. Like you see, verse 6. Mm-hmm. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four living creatures, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb, as though it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent forth into all the earth. So far, grammar is correct.
Yes.
Nothing wrong. Right? Lamb, yeah. Animal, it. Right.
It.
Okay?
Yeah.
Any argument?
No.
No. Okay. No. Now, verse 7. Mm-hmm. And he came and took the scroll. So, how did the lamb, it became he? Something happened, you know?
Yes.
Between verse 6 and verse 7, mm-hmm, the it became he.
He, yeah.
What happened?
Well, I with my little understanding, I would have to say that the lamb transformed into Yeshua.
Exactly. That's how the respected prophet of God saw it. Mm. The lamb transformed
into
as the Lord Yeshua. Mm. So from the animal that was slain, mm-hmm, was transformed as the Lord Yeshua. Even then, when the Lord Yeshua came there, you don't read that all the 24 elders bowed down to worship him, no?
No.
They did not.
No.
Why? They should, isn't it?
They should, yeah. But I you have to explain that. You know, I don't want to speak about my knowledge.
Logical
answer. We're talking spiritual things.
Okay, tell me, let me hear audience. What your logical viewpoint.
Well, I would have to say that they, you know, logical answer would be that they saw first just the lamb. Mm. And then when it transformed into Yeshua, maybe they realized who he really was. Mm. And maybe, and when he went and sat down on the throne is when they threw their crowns down, no? Maybe they recognized that the Son and the Father were one, and they were paying respect then. That's my logical answer.
Okay. But even then, they only see something is taking place here. He was standing there.
Yes.
But none of them paid any respect to him or worshipped him. Okay, that would be a better word to use.
Yes.
They did not worship him. But as soon as he took the scroll, another clue is found in verse 4 when the Apostle John wept so much that nobody was worthy to open the scroll.
Yes.
Then one of the elders told him, don't worry, don't weep. There's only one person who's worthy. That is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. For he hath prevailed.
Yes.
For he has overcome. Initially, when the Lord Yeshua came and stood there, he stood there as a representative of men.
Yes.
One who has overcome.
Yes.
That means he is qualified to take the scroll now.
Yes.
But after he took the scroll, something changed. Like all the honor, power, authority that has been now given to him for ruling, reigning. Reign as a king, as king has been now given to him. That's when they all began to bow down and worship him.
So almost like in the logical way, it was his inaugural day to be the president.
Right. Yes. See, the clue is found here, no?
Yeah.
For you have made them unto our God a kingdom of priests and they shall reign on the earth. See? Like a kingship, no?
Yes.
Like he became now the king.
Yes.
Kingship has been given to him now.
Uh-huh.
I want to encourage you and all of you, my precious saints and brothers and sisters, you should listen to the full message that the respected servant of God or prophet of God, Vincent Salukoman, shared in detail about this powerful encounter that he had in with God, where he was shown all this in greater detail. You should please order the DVD, the advertisement that you see, you will see on the screen shortly. So there he shares in greater detail how he was graced by God to see this vision in great detail, you know. And after that, when they all begin to worship him and adore him, because he has now received a kingdom. A kingdom has been given to him. That's why they say, no, a kingdom of priests. And we shall now reign on the earth.
I see.
So after this, the kingdom of God is coming down to the earth to reign. So with that, now you see what is written here. In verse 13, and every creature that is in heaven, what would you say every creature in heaven?
I would have to say, you know, the seraphims and the cherubims and other.
So which means
high
all the angelic creation, all the living beings, except the elders or other saints, no?
Right.
Those, right? Agreed?
Yes, yes.
Okay. And on the earth.
Yes.
So, every creature on the earth. So, what is every creature on the earth?
Every, you know, including us.
Okay. And under the sea. So, what is every creature under the sea?
The, you know, the devil.
No, in the sea.
Oh, in the sea, I see, okay.
Sea creatures, no?
Sea creatures.
Right?
Right.
And all that are in them. How does your Amplified reads?
Well, the Amplified reads, and on the sea, and all that is in it, crying out together.
So that means, not only the living creatures in the sea, but something else
in them. In them.
What is in something else that's in the sea?
The Spirit of God.
Okay, no. We don't know, no? It's the scriptures
mystery.
Are silent. Yes.
Another mystery.
Okay. They all are praising God.
Yes.
Saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him. right?
Yes.
So, which means the entire creation in heaven, on earth and below the sea are all now worshipping the Lord Yeshua, who is now crowned as king.
Yes.
Because a kingdom has been given to him. And greater mysteries about all this will be revealed to us from time to time. Mm-hmm. So now he has become the king.
The king, yeah.
So here you see, all this, the verses that I wanted to show you was verse 13. Another mystery here. Mm-hmm. Every creature that is in heaven, mm-hmm, and on the earth and under the earth. Under the earth, what is under the earth? Oh, we missed that, no?
Yeah.
On the earth and under the earth. I thought you mentioned something about?
The demonic realm.
Under the earth. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, how are they going to hear? How will they know that something has happened in heaven? So, somehow a communication has been made, you know?
Yes.
Right?
Right.
So, in the last days, in some manner, which the Spirit of God will determine, mm-hmm, how, we do not know right now, but I'm sure it will be made known, a communication will be made that everything that has breath,
yes,
will hear.
Ah, I see.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Everything that has breath will hear. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And molecules are alive.
Yes.
They are matter. They all are alive, no?
Right.
So once, if they are alive, they can respond to sound and light.
That's right.
So, the airwaves, which carry sound, going by that logical reasoning, can affect molecules.
Yes.
And can affect matter.
Yes.
So, which means any matter in any of the three realms, mm-hmm, the sound and light
can affect
them.
Yes.
Which means they can hear.
Yes.
Isn't it?
That's right.
So, when that crowning of the Lord Yeshua is declared, mm-hmm, when he takes the scroll, and then he is being declared, so to speak,
as king.
As now king. Mm-hmm. And that kingship is for reigning on the earth, no?
Yes.
So that's what we need to pay attention to. Mm. That is for reigning on the earth. The ultimate reign is the 1,000-year millennium rule.
Right.
But before that, the spiritual kingdom comes to rule on this earth through the church.
That's right.
Because for the one final harvest, that needs to be done.
Right.
The invisible and the visible.
Invisible, yeah.
So when that happens, then everything under the earth, in the sea and in them.
Well,
so that means there are two realms in the earth, two realms in the sea.
Right. Right.
The depths, the deeper understanding of it, we do not know right now. But the scripture is sufficient for us to tell us something is there.
Yes. Yes.
So all these mysteries are all in that
scroll.
Scroll that the angel has. Mm. So when that angel gives that scroll, mm-hmm, now, if you will turn back to Revelation chapter 10. That scroll is in the hands of that angel.
Yes.
And in the days of the voice of the seventh angel. Mm-hmm. So, when the seventh angel blows his trumpet, then the mystery of God should be
revealed.
So, when that is revealed, then if you read in verse 8, John hears a voice saying, go and take that scroll. Mm. So when he eats it, after he has eaten, mm-hmm, then he was told in verse 11, now you must prophesy to many peoples, nations, tongues and kings. Mm. Right?
Yes.
So the revelations that are contained in that
scroll
will give the ability to broadcast or telecast through one person and then through a group of people, mm-hmm, that will go throughout all the world. Mm-hmm. So it says all people, all nations, all tongues, all, mm-hmm, kings.
Right.
So this word, this revelation should go to all nations and all tongues, different languages. Mm-hmm. It must be go,
right.
Made ready, mm-hmm. then the word will go forth.
Wow.
So such great, wonderful revelations that were sealed from the beginning of time.
Mm.
Like for example, you have heard of Atlantis, you know?
Yes.
Okay. Is it real or fable?
I would say real.
Real.
Mm-hmm.
Where is it?
That's a tough question.
It is like in the twilight zone, you know.
Yeah.
Real, but not real.
Mm-hmm.
In between. Twilight zone.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Okay. Now, mysteries like that. And the first flood on the earth, when did it take place?
During time of Noah.
No. Sorry, sir.
Is it?
Minus one point. Wrong
okay.
answer.
Okay.
It took place even eons before that.
Hmm.
Genesis chapter 1,
mm-hmm.
verse 1 and verse 2, it says, see, God created the seas much later.
Okay.
But in verse 2 it says, and darkness covered the earth and the Spirit of God moved upon the waters.
Oh, okay.
So where did those waters come from?
They were existing, God, you know, they were existing before the earth was made then.
Something happened, no?
Right.
So there was a first flood.
Oh, okay.
Antediluvian flood.
Oh,
that's
okay.
what the theologians call it.
Okay.
The first flood.
Mm-hmm.
So something mysterious happened.
Mm-hmm.
Before the creation of man.
Oh, okay.
Which the Bible is silent about.
Mm-hmm.
Which, if you read in the book of Enoch, mm-hmm. there's some answers there.
Mm.
And there were great cities, you know, like Atlantis.
Oh, okay.
During those times.
Okay.
And God sent a flood and destroyed the first creation.
Oh.
The first flood came at that time.
Okay.
How many years ago, we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Then the Holy Spirit came, moved upon the waters, recreated the earth.
Oh, I see.
So that is a mystery there.
Yes.
What happened there, we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
See, like, dinosaurs, are they real or unreal? Or is it Twilight Zone?
Twilight Zone.
But bones have been found, you know.
Yeah.
So is it Twilight Zone or real?
They are real. It's probably is like you're saying, we don't know.
Right.
You know?
See, it's not like Atlantis, you know.
Right.
We cannot say it's imaginary, yet it is, we cannot say it's real.
Mm-hmm.
So that I say is Twilight Zone.
Mm-hmm.
But dinosaur bones have all been unearthed.
Right.
Fossils are there to prove that they really existed.
Yes.
Like mammoth.
Mm-hmm.
So those, they have even unearthed mammoth, you know.
Yes.
Not Ice Age, you know.
Right.
The cartoon.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This
no,
is the real.
Real. Yeah.
Right, you have seen, right?
Yeah.
So they were all real.
Mm-hmm.
Geologists tell us, which I'm sure you know very well, that millions of years ago, when the dinosaurs ruled the world,
mm-hmm.
a meteor came and destroyed everything.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you know this.
Yeah.
I don't think that is the right interpretation. It is the first flood that destroyed them
all. That, yeah.
That there was a first creation.
Mm-hmm.
That all these big creatures
mm-hmm.
were there.
Mm-hmm.
And when Lucifer first fell to earth,
mm.
that's how this creation got corrupted.
Oh, okay.
You know? And God had to destroy all that.
I see.
All the wonderful cities.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how this Atlantis all ended up.
Oh, okay.
All the cities, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But even then, there is more mystery to that.
Mm-hmm.
Which will be revealed. in the days to come, when these seals are all broken, when the mystery of God are made known to us. And the most amazing will be, I think the most glorious revelation will be things concerning the Godhead, that which have been puzzling us, like how God been one, separated himself to incarnate on the earth, and what actually took place at the birth of the Lord Yeshua. Is it how it really happened, like how we read in the story of Nativity? Or how did the star guide it? It cannot be a real star, you know.
No.
Because real stars don't move.
Right.
Where else? Here it says the star moved. And it came and stood over Bethlehem. Can you imagine a real star coming and standing over Bethlehem?
No.
It will destroy the earth, you know.
That's right.
Because of the brightness of the
star.
Glory.
Yeah.
So what is that? All that, you know. Yeah. All this mystery, and there is another mystery I wanted to share with you, but unfortunately,
okay,
I have to say goodbye to you.
Okay,
right now we have to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Whether you will change your t-shirt or not, I don't know, because I see you are very excited.
I am. I can't, you know, wait for the morning to come so I can find out about this mystery.
All right then, please. Have a little sip before you go.
Yes.
And we'll meet tomorrow.
Okay.
My dear brothers and sisters, I'm sure you're enjoying our little family time here as well as our family time together. For more information about this program, or if you want to send your comments, you can send to the email address that you see on your screen, or you can visit our web page, website, Facebook and Twitter. We'll meet again tomorrow. God bless you.
Dear viewers from Spain, please send us your testimonies and feedback if you are blessed by this program. Email ID atv.spanish@angeltv.org.